The platform behavior is used to add the basic functionality found in platform games, with a side-scrolling, running, and jumping style of movement. Let's take a look at how to get an object set up with the platform behavior in Construct 2. Here, we've got a basic platform style layout set up, with a player character. Each of the ground and platform objects have the solid behavior applied to them. Let's go ahead and add the platform behavior to the player object. Select the player, click on Behaviors, select Add New, and select the platform behavior under the Movements category. Let's preview the layout and see how an object with the platform behavior is controlled. Pressing the left or right arrow keys allows the player to move, and pressing the up key lets the player jump. The block on the ground has the solid behavior applied, and objects with the solid behavior will block the platform's object's path. Jumping underneath this platform will also block the player. The player's jump strength is a little low right now, but if it were set higher, we could jump onto these platforms. Let's set the jump strength a little higher so we can do that. Right now, the jump speed is set to 650, which is the speed of the jump in pixels per second. Let's set it to 850, and preview the layout again. Now, we can jump onto each of these platforms, and since the platforms have the solid behavior applied, we can stand on them, and they prevent us from falling. I'm sure you noticed how the player's sprite is animated correctly, depending on what the player's doing at that moment. When he stands, the idle animation is playing. Moving left or right causes the running animation to play, and jumping triggers the jump animation. The platform behavior lets you easily set up this functionality. In the event sheet, I have some events already set up. Each of these events are available under Platform Animation Triggers. Let's run through them real quick. First, we have Platform On Moved, which sets the player to the run animation anytime its speed is not equal to zero. Next, we have Platform On Stopped, which switches back to the idle animation when the object's speed reaches zero. The On Jump event switches the animation to the jump animation anytime the player's sprite is moving upwards. The opposite of this is On Fall, which is triggered when the player is moving downwards. On Landed is triggered when the sprite stops falling, and it sets the sprite back to the idle animation. Last, we have Is Moving, which is triggered if the object is in motion. Now, let's take a look at some of the properties we can adjust on an object with the platform behavior. First, we have Max Speed, which is the maximum speed the object can reach in pixels per second. Then, we have Acceleration, which is the rate the object can accelerate at until it reaches its max speed. Acceleration is also in pixels per second. Deceleration is the rate at which the object will slow down after it's no longer accelerating. We've already looked at jump strength earlier, but after that, we have gravity. Gravity works like acceleration does. It accelerates by that number of pixels per second, except gravity accelerates towards the bottom of the screen. This way, as you're jumping, gravity will slowly begin to pull you back down until your speed reverses and you fall to the ground. This is also affected by the next property, max fall speed. Max fall speed is the maximum speed in pixels per second that this object will reach when accelerated by gravity. So we can set this value to a much lower number, and our player object will only fall at that rate and no faster. Let's try 100 pixels per second. If I preview the layout and jump, you can see as he starts falling, he only reaches 100 pixels per second and just drifts to the ground, almost like he's parachuting. Let's set the max fall speed back to 1000 for now. Next, we have double jump, which, if enabled, allows the player to jump and then jump again mid-air, giving you a double jump. I'll enable it and preview the layout. And you can see, when I press the up arrow twice, I can double jump. Last, we have jump sustain. This allows you to sustain your jump for longer if you're holding the jump key down. The value is in milliseconds, so a value of 1000 would allow you to sustain your jump for 1 second while holding the jump key down. Let me show you what I mean. I'll set the jump strength to 450, and the jump sustain to 1000. If I preview the layout, and I just tap the jump key, we get the standard jump, with a strength of 450 pixels per second. But if I press the jump key and hold it down, the jump is sustained for up to 1 second, or until I release the key. This allows for larger jumps while the player's holding the key down. All of this functionality can be set up manually, but by using the platform behavior, you can save yourself tons of time, as well as frustration, since all of the basic platform abilities are already built in. Give the platform behavior a try, and see what you can come up with.